This is just a glimpse, a little reality check of what we call being a senior, the roller coaster life of an 18-year-old.
Put it on my rice, put it on my burger, put it in my jar. Then you come on over and we'll eat pickles every day. Together we'll pickle every each, every way. Pickles every Wednesday.
Improv.
And then I eat it and then I go to the fair. Outside my pickle, everybody stops to stare. Yeah, they wanna find my
pickle. My initial thoughts of the senior class when he came in ninth grade was impressed about how involved you guys got in right away. Just jumped in with both feet across the board. It was unusual.
For me, it's very odd. The senior class started in ninth grade, and you were babies. You were actual babies. I think I've said that. Actual babies who could not sit still. Hello, Sammy Galati. And literally bouncing in their chairs, and now to see how some of you have matured into 18-year-old adults, it's unbelievable to me to see the growth of people.
You guys are so cute. You're all eager and adorable, and I mean, that seems to be my primary feeling. I was teaching you in downstairs in 185. And it was so sunny all the time, and I feel like that kind of matched the mood of y'all. That's how I remember y'all, sunshiny.
So, when I first met you, I heard good things, and it was first time at the retreat, and I was excited. I didn't know anyone, and you were all just too nice and cute, and from the first second listen to me. And one of the students that were staying with you in the cabin said to me, "Oh wait, they're afraid of you." And it's like, "Oh no, they don't know me. What do you mean they're afraid of me?" So then I said, "Okay, I have to change their mind, but still, you know, figure out how I get a hold of 115 students altogether." So I think from the first second, I just loved your the way you were as a class, the way you reacted to each other, and how respectful you were.
What's a word that describes this senior class the most accurately? In one word? Bonded. You guys are bonded in a different way than I've seen groups in the past. Certainly you saw cliques before. Every year you always see these cliques that bond. And you see some class bonding, but right at the beginning of this year, when you guys had your beach day, your turnout was huge, way bigger than any other class has ever been. Bonded, going with bonded.
One word? I'm gonna go hope. When I see young people like this, it gives me hope for the future. It gives me, you know, hope that America is gonna be all right.
Resilience. I've seen that time and time again. When Sam, when his life was in danger, so many students, those who could, gave blood. Turned him, gave, that's something unusual for your average teenage kid. And then just the normal day-to-day amidst the pandemic, Cooper working as a movie usher, and Lynn working at a restaurant while providing motherly advice and a friendly ear to so many students. And Asher flying across the country to take part in a international climate change demonstration. Just the determination not to be defeated by all the tragedy and the challenges that were thrown, and that's on top of everyday teenage stuff, social activities, sports, AP tests, etc. So I would say more than most or other grades I've taught in the last 22 years, resilience is the first thing to do.
I've never had a class that has gone through so many tragedies, if you will, and you've all come out stronger than I've ever seen a class come out before, because, you know, I think there are a few paths for how to handle some not such good things, and your class, like, has chosen the strong, keep it together, like, we need each other path, which is, I think, what separates your class from just any senior class, because I used to teach seniors in my old school, and I've never seen anything like this.
I think this class has affected the school. I mean, you endured so many more things than the average senior class. I think you embody all the social change that we're seeing happening in the world. So your grade has introduced anti-racism activism in a way I haven't seen here before. You've brought LGBTQ plus issues to the forefront in a way I've never seen before. You've brought trauma awareness to the forefront in a way I've never seen before. I think that you, more than any other grade that I've witnessed, are just the embodiment of your times.
The class affected the school in, like I said, leadership. So the TOF program started off with idea that the class brought up. Many clubs, it's the class that has the most on the dean's list. It's the class that has changed, so students left and students came, stayed the biggest class. Everybody around the faculty room says that it's the nicest class that we've had for years. Between the people who are leading it and the people who are part of the class, and the maturity, the respect, the just the approach overall. If I'm gonna miss you, I just started crying already. The fact that you're going to leave, oh my gosh, so much, so much. I would, if I could and I can, would host every year a reunion in the summer in my house, so you can all come and I can all see you and we can all get together.
Will I miss your grade? I will miss all of you but one girl, not so much.
Yeah. I won't miss your grade.
I will miss individuals from your grade. You know, it's hard to miss an abstraction. You miss people. So yeah, there's a lot of people I'll miss. There's been people that have really, really gone into my heart this year, you know? I don't want to name people because I'll start not naming people then too, by the same token. But there's absolutely individuals in this class that I will really miss quite a bit.
Are you kidding? It's going to be, it's already sad that I don't get my hugs. I don't get to see I call them my babies. It's already sad for me to begin with, let alone next year. It's going to be really hard to not see them at all.
Yeah, of course, man. Bless you guys. You had a great time. Awesome year. So many good memories. I hope you guys come back. Say hi to us. You'll miss the magic
of the good. My brother's a senior, so I've known a lot of you for a while, and honestly, love you guys, super close.
I love the senior class. I got really close with them this year, and they're great, and I'm going to miss them next year, so yeah.
I think they bring a lot of energy to the school, and they have crazy good energy. They got the chaperone.
Yeah, they're really close, and it's nice to see how much they bond with each other.
We love them, they're very school spirited.
Yes. Lots of energy.
Yeah. What I think about the senior class is I think they're really great and they're really supportive.
Energetic.
I think they're very crazy, but very loving and cute, so I love them and they appreciate all the love.
I think it's a wonderful class, especially this person right here, Eliana Becker.
My favorite senior.
My favorite freshman.
They're really nice. I know Maddie, she was on my tennis team and she was like really nice to me at Elkman.
I think they're all right. They're all very friendly, which I appreciate, and they don't act like any other grade's superiors, which is nice.
Mr. Levine, what do you think of the senior class?
Yikes.
The senior class this year was incredible. I think that they're a really fun one. They're nice and they're really cute.
Personally, I love the senior class in more ways than one. I love everyone in it. We're gonna miss you guys next year for sure.
The seniors for me were really impactful because I felt like they were my parents, you know, like someone I could look up to and who already went through the experience I needed to go through and I could help.
I think the senior class was really influential in my junior year experience because they really just paved the way for me as a rising senior.
Love you, seniors.
Advice is the same advice I always gave, is to read the news from a variety of different perspectives as much as you can. And I'm talking full-length articles, not short Twitter blurbs or Instagram stuff or what you hear on Facebook or Friends, but to read the full cross-section of different points of view, even those, maybe even most importantly, those you disagree with. So I would say read as much as you can, take part in your life, civic, political, personal, and always fight for democracy and democratic values.
My best advice for your class is to make time for the extra. You've been in school and it always goes from A period to B period, and so many of you are going into more school next year, and you go from this class to that class, and the system takes care of your progress, but you better find what the extra thing in your life is that is not scheduled for you already and learn how to make time for that. It's a hard skill, but the most important.
I have one last piece of advice for your class. Keep learning. Keep learning. Don't look at learning as something that is only happens in school or, you know, college or something like that. It's not. The whole point of school is to teach you to be autodidactic, to teach yourself so you know how to learn, because you have to keep learning. Meaningful experiences can be had through continued learning. You can learn a new language at any age. I learned Spanish, I started at 60 when I learned Spanish. Keep traveling. If you don't know how to surfboard, how to surfboard. How to surf, learn to surf. Snowboard, learn new things. Learn to play chess, learn new card games. I learned a new card game, a Russian card game, at Shabbaton. It was really fun. I lost every one, but it was really fun. Keep learning. I really think it's the secret to youth and the secret to meaning in life, you know? That's my advice to this class, keep learning.
It's the thing I tell
seniors anytime when I teach seniors, but you have the ability to make choices. And that's something that we undervalue, I think. We don't pay enough attention to the choices that we make and the responsibility that that carries. You all have within you the ability to make really beautiful things with your lives. And I see how purposefully you're already living as a grade. So I have no doubt that you'll do this. But my advice is to choose wisely and not underestimate happiness. It can be found in so many places, and you're certainly so very deserving.
Be curious. Continue to be curious, to try things. Use your heart and your ideas. I know we have a lot of creative thinkers and innovators. Use your ideas. Don't worry about social media, getting likes. All of that is nonsense. Go with what's in here, because you guys have a lot of heart as a class.
Man, enjoy the ride. You're about to enter, you know, the best part of life. Embrace it. Anytime you get an opportunity to do something different, fun, weird, do it. Say yes. Say yes to life. You know, you only get it once. Make the most out of it.
Advice for the class: work on your self-esteem. If you believe in yourself, you can do anything that you wish to do. And I can definitely see great things that people in our grade will do. And the one thing is just, you know, believe in yourself. Believe that you can do it. Ask for help if you can't. Work hard, and you'll get there.
It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.